Let's go to Gringotts, the Wizard's Bank. Ain't no safer place. Not one. Except, perhaps, Hogwarts.
Hagrid, what exactly are these creatures?
They're goblins. Clever bunch, but pretty unfriendly. Stay close, Harry. Mr. Harry Potter wishes to make a withdrawal.
Does Mr. Harry Potter have his key?
Wait a minute. Ha! Here it is. Oh wait, there's something else. Professor Dumbledore gave this to me. It's about you know what, in vault you know which.
Very well, follow me.
Hagrid, what was that about? What's you know what?
I'm not supposed to tell you this, Harry, but let's just say it is about a very powerful object. Professor Dumbledore entrusted me with it.
I've heard rumors that the object is some kind of stone.
Who told you? No one is supposed to know. Well, since you already know what it is, let me tell you a bit more about the Philosopher's Stone. Basically, it's a stone that could turn any metal into pure gold, and it can grant a person immortality.
Previously, Harry, Ron, and Hermione tried their luck at the life-size board of Wizard's Chess. The chess set was enchanted to protect the Philosopher's Stone at Hogwarts. They must win the game in order to advance to the next stage. I'm not supposed to be talking about this, but if you must know, there is a way to win.
We play.
Ron, you don't suppose this is going to be like real Wizard's Chess, do you? Pawn to d5. Yes, Hermione, I think this is going to be exactly like Wizard's Chess.
Castle to e4.
Hermione, this isn't working. We tried multinomial regression previously to predict who might win the game, but the accuracy was just 52%, which is horrible. Let's try something else.
What about gradient boosting, the machine learning technique?
It starts from fitting an initial model to the data, and then another model is built to focus on predicting the cases that performed poorly in the first model.
That sounds like a great idea. The boosting process is repeated many times, and each successive model attempts to overcome the shortcomings of the combined boosted ensemble. Let's see if the model accuracy can be improved using gradient boosting.
You can use fivefold cross-validation.
What's cross-validation, Hermione?
Cross-validation is a sampling method that uses different portions of the data to test and train a model. The goal is to test the model's ability to predict new data that it had not seen before. Five-fold cross-validation involves separating the data into five subsets. Each time, one of the five subsets is used as the test set and the other four subsets are put together to form a training set. The purpose of this is to develop a generalized model that can perform well on unseen data. First, we use the train control function from the caret package to set the parameters for the train function. Number refers to the number of resampling iterations. In the case of fivefold cross-validation, the number is specified as 5. Looking good, Hermione. Then, we can use the train function to fit the model. Look, Harry, the accuracy of the train dataset is 67%. This is way better than what we had before using multinomial regression, which was only 52%. That's right. Let's run the prediction on the test dataset using the predict function. The accuracy of the test dataset is 66%. Okay, we're getting somewhere. Can we also try decision trees, Hermione? Yes, we can. Decision tree is a type of supervised machine learning method. The aim is to create a model that predicts who wins at chess by learning simple decision rules. That's right. For more details on decision trees, go ahead and check out the Squid Game Marbles video. Let's use the rpart function to fit a model on the train dataset. And, as with the previous example on gradient boosting, let's use the predict function to predict the winners. The accuracy this time with decision trees is 67% on the train dataset. As for the test dataset, the accuracy is 66%. We can use the rpartplot function to plot the tree. Looking good, Hermione. So according to this graph, the overall chances of White winning at the top is 59%. Then, the note asks whether the adjusted ELO difference is less than 0.015. If the answer is yes, follow the root notes, left child note, and so on.
So to conclude, in our previous episode, we ran multinomial regression and had an accuracy of 52% on the test dataset. This time, both gradient boosting and decision tree returned an accuracy of 66%. It's an improvement, isn't it? But is it enough for us to win? Wait a minute. You understand, right, Harry? Once I make my move, the queen will take me. Then you're free to check the king. Ron! No! What is it? He's going to sacrifice himself. No, you can't. There must be another way. Do you want to get the stone or not? Harry, it is you that has to go on. I know it. Not me. Not Hermione. You. Knight to H3.